you doing today, folks? Welcome again. Welcome, everyone, to the Hardball Profits Way. This is American Management's podcast, and we have been around for 34 years, and we started this podcast several weeks ago. So this is a business management podcast for any owner, entrepreneur, aspiring owner, giraffe, elephant, anybody that wants to create wealth and build a business for themselves, wants to improve operations, maximize profit, and grow their business. The Hardball Profits Way is for you. Hi again, my name's Lou Mosca. Kevin would tell me I need to slow down, but my name is Lou Mosca, and joining me on this episode is once again my good friend and director of management services, Michael. I can grill or smoke anything. How are you today, Mike?
Doing pretty well. Pretty well. Thank you.
So how'd those bratwursts turn out last night?
The pizza was fantastic.
Very good. Very good. Just never got to cooking, right?
Never got to it.
It's actually, my wife said to me the other day, this is amazing. You used to be able to come home and turn it off for a little bit. He said, now your days are going to about 8 o'clock at night. And I'm like, it's just the way it is. The other night, we got a call at 11:30 from an owner in California wanting to help him. And we took the call. So, you know, at American Management, we believe that an owner's biggest obstacle to growth and success is just not having and not working a formal plan. That includes a plan for operations, financials. And of course, developing what we would call a predetermined profit, which we're going to be discussing in a future podcast, is what I'm told. Is that right, Mike?
That's right.
Okay. So now, after 34 years, one of the most critical areas we found owners lacking is a plan, really having a dedicated plan to help them get through specific areas. So, Michael, I know we've sort of broken this thing down into three issues or three areas that we've been working with our clients and people that have been calling us on our 855 number to try and get advice. And we've broken it into three areas, right? We talked the first area on one of our first podcasts was about people. Wasn't that the first one, Mike?
That's right.
Second one was about the integrity of your operation and your organization.
Correct.
And the third area that we think everybody needs to focus on is dough. It's liquidity, right? So on today's episode, we're going to discuss preserving your liquidity. And we've sort of titled this, Preparing Yourself for 3 Months of Hell. So today is Friday, what month are we in? April 3rd. And what's today supposed to be, Mike?
It's a big day, probably a landmark day. This is the day that they opened up, banks opened up taking applications for the Payroll Protection Program, the $349 billion injection for small businesses backed by the SBA. Big day.
Isn't it amazing? $349 billion. It's like $1.99 for gas. It's like Walmart's rollback signs for 99 cents. Who comes up with these numbers, right? So we're either an economy that is way out of budget and a huge deficit, and we just keep throwing more zeros. $349 billion, not 350, $349 billion. That's just insane to me.
When you consider it was $2 trillion in total, $349 is a drop in the bucket.
Yeah, it's only like 11%, 12%. Right. It's not even a big piece of the pie, right? So, you know, and so let's talk about that for a second. So we're working with our active clients. We've been advising all the people that have called us and our active clients to beware of this economic disaster loan, right? And to apply for the PPP. And we're not going to give the mechanics today on how to do both or where to go for it, other than to say the economic disaster loan you do directly through SBA.gov and the PPP/CARES program you do directly through your commercial lender. Is that correct?
That's correct.
Okay. So when we talk about liquidity, we're talking about the viability of your business, your balance sheet, your money, your ability to pay your bills, your working capital. So what are we talking about with our clients and what are we seeing and hearing, Mike?
Well, let's back up real quick. The first thing that, and I know we've personally, between you and I, have had this conversation. I think the starting point is, I would say, if you had a crappy balance sheet going into coronavirus, nothing that's happening today with the injections, with the help that the government's offering, is going to get you out of that situation. So
is that a consulting phrase, by the way, a crappy balance sheet?
That's industry specific terminology that I'm using there.
So you're in trouble.
Right. But, so I think, you know, and we've said this in the other sections of this, that you got to be real with the situation. And, you know, we're never shy on saying, if you don't have cash, then you don't have anything. So while we realize that you got to take care of your people and you got to maintain the integrity of your business, which were the earlier parts of this series, cash is king. It's always has been, always will be. So, we want to make sure, and what we're preaching to our clients is, you know, you've got to know, soup to nuts, what your cash position is, not just today, but how long you're going to be able to sustain through this period of time. Because the reality is we don't know if this thing's going to be shut down for 3 months. That's what we fundamentally believe. It certainly could go longer. But the other thing that I'm adding to this is, with the rollout of the payroll protection program and this economic impact disaster loans and all these things that are offering, I've been just personally, my gut feel is that could take 2 months to fund. So you have to be able to manage your cash and your business from the point that you started being impacted through this, through whatever unforeseen period of time that's out there. And I wouldn't necessarily count on all this money just coming into you anytime real soon to do this. So in other words, if you're not operating the way you should be from a liquidity standpoint, you gotta pay attention to that right now.
I had a gentleman call yesterday. I took the call. He is a distributor of food products, but it is a discretionary food product, right? It's not eggs or milk or toilet paper or whatever it is. And I don't think that's a food product, but there's discretionary food product he distributes. And it's not a big business. He's doing about $250,000 a year. And he wanted to know what kind of grants were out there, what kind of quote unquote free money could he get, but he has no employees. Right. So you start with no employees, kind of tough to take advantage of the PPP program. Right. So I guided him to the other program. And of course, he went into, I don't want to borrow money. I said, so liquidity wise, I respect you for not wanting to borrow money. Liquidity wise, where you at? I'm overdrawn. OK, how are you doing getting product? I can't get any. My distributor won't sell to me because I don't have money. Well, that happened before today. Right. Right. That happened before today. We can't fix. Right? Two arms that have already been amputated and you want to be able to go play baseball. It's kind of difficult to do that. Had another circumstance the other day with an owner in Portland, Oregon, did about $300,000 last year in business. And he is in the event planning business and he hosts these events and he does the marketing for these events. Very gregarious young fellow, right? And when everyone went on a shutdown or a stay-at-home order, all of his events canceled. So he had to give back deposits that he had, which wiped out half of his liquidity. So that's someone living on other people's money, right? He had to give back his deposits, wiped out half his liquidity. And he told me how much cash he had in the bank. And I said, let's lay out what you need in cash for 3 months, for April, for May, and for June. And let's figure out if we have enough with what you have to get you there. And I asked him to do that, and he didn't want to do it.
Insane.
Right? Insane, right? Didn't want to do it. So I find it to be that if the folks that don't want to do it are folks that know they're really in deep crapola, you know, that consulting word you used before.
But I'm also finding that the people that are reluctant to do those types of things are also the people that are kind of sitting on their hands in regards to educating themselves on what's going to be available out there. And I've been pretty clear, I think, in all our conversations. I'm not relying on the government assistance. I think it'll come, but I'm not relying on that. I'm trying to tell our clients and our business owners that you have to be able to weather the storm. If this is going to be truly 3 months of hell, don't count on that money coming in. And if the money does eventually come, then that's great. Good. You're prepared for that. But what if it does take 2 to 3 months before that money comes? And we don't know at this point because I can tell you that the rollout of the, at least what I'm hearing and from our guys out in the field and our business owners that we're working with, is that this has been a less than stellar event rolling in. A lot of difficulties. Banks, I think, are kind of hedging because they're uncertain as to how this whole thing works. And that's just going to add more time and more confusion in the coming days. It's certainly going to delay the money getting into the hands of the owners. But, you know, so I always take an approach when you're doing your cash forecasting and your sustainability, how many weeks can I last with what's going on? Don't include any of that money in there. In other words, run the business as the situation is today. And if you're able to have some semblance of business and cash flow coming in and out, and there's a lot out there that's kind of relatively normal, I should say, use that. But if you're somebody that's a non-essential business, let's say, that's significantly impacted, then at some point you're going to have to make hard decisions. But you got to start with that cash projection, because if you don't know how far you can go into the future, you know, again, that's not a plan. You don't know where you're eventually going to cut off. And we talked in these episodes about protecting your people, protecting your operations. And again, as mentioned earlier, cash is king, right? If you don't have cash, then you're not going to have people and you're not going to have an operation. So I think a lot of our owners are struggling with the concept of, hey, I want to take care of my people. I want to make sure that they're available. And if I got to furlough them, I can bring them back and that type of thing. But without wrapping that into a cash plan, you know, I think what's happening with a lot of our clients is they're putting more precedence on the people in that. And I can understand why, because of people, you know, you don't want to hurt them. But I just feel like if you don't do that and you're just trying to focus on making sure I have my people and they're made whole and they're taken care of, you risk everybody in your organization that way. I'd rather make the hard decision on a handful of people that may be uncomfortable for me to do, but helps me preserve my liquidity and ultimately my business, than to not pay attention to that and risk everybody out there. Because if I can't go another 4 or 5 weeks, and that's kind of the time period that most of our business owners that we're talking to, I think, have realistically, they can stretch out a month, but a lot of them can't go much further than that. Well, what's going to happen if you get to the end of that month? Are you going to hope that the government money comes in and you're okay? Or are you just going to fizzle out when that happens, or not be able to make your payroll at that point, or whatever the case may be? So I think starting with your cash sustainability, cash flow forecast, see where you're at. And then you're going to have to make some tough decisions along the way to make sure that you're preserving liquidity so that you can stretch that amount of time out.
You know, my brother and I did business with someone a million years ago, and he used to preach, you can't have too much month left at the end of the money, right? And, you know, so if you got enough money to get to the 20th, you got 10 or 11 days to bridge. That's not a way of doing business. Same thing with individuals, right? People holding out that they're going to get that $800, $900, $1,100, $1,200 check from the feds, you know, that stimulus check, thinking it's going to show up in time to pay their bills on the 10th of April, I think are making a big mistake, right? You need to go on the offensive with people and tell them what you can and you can't do. But I just think that from a liquidity perspective, right, it is a fair and noble thing to want to protect your employees, because the integrity of your company is usually based around the integrity of your employees. Of course, to what degree? So I think you need to have clear lines of communication with your bank. You need to be talking to them often. I bet you I spoke to our representative at PNC 3 times already today. And quite frankly, we're in pretty good shape. We're actually deferring and carrying receivables from folks that we shouldn't have to be doing. In the normal times, we would not be doing. But we are today, because it's the right thing to do to a degree. But we spent 34 years building a strong balance sheet to protect American management. Did we know coronavirus was coming? No, but it's the right thing to do, period.
Well, that falls under the guideline of, if you have a strong balance sheet going in, you're better equipped to weather this than not. And, you know, for those that have a strong balance sheet, there's a, you know, I've talked to some business owners like this, that they're not worried about the government programs. They're applying and they're doing the things they need to do because it's available and that's just the right thing to do in protecting their business, but they're not relying on it, which is a great position to be in. And, you know, what we're trying to focus on are clients that don't necessarily have a good balance sheet and some of the things that they can do. So, you know, again, recommendation right off the bat is, you know, do your week-to-week cash flow forecast. How far into the future can you go with how your operations have been impacted? How much cash do you have in hand today, availability to borrow? And then, you know, what's your cash flows coming in and going out every week to determine where you're going to be at? And obviously the point you get to negative is how far you have in the future. And then you got to start putting a plan. Now, when we developed our plan with our clients, we did this before CARES Act and before EIDL were common terms.
Before COVID-19 was even a term.
Absolutely. So, you know, and one of the things that we had in our plan that we laid out with our clients is you have to have a payroll strategy for your employees, because again, you can't just assume that it's status quo. You know, let's say for instance, your cash flow is half of what it was. And quite honestly, that's probably pretty good in this day and age. There's a lot of businesses that have zero going into this. Obviously you're not gonna be able to pay everybody and keep everybody running.
So our cash flow last week was half of what it normally was.
Right.
This week, it's a third of what it normally was.
That's right.
And we don't expect it to improve next week, do we?
Nope, it's going to...
Is a third going to go to 100% next week?
No.
Are we happy about it?
No.
But we're going to be okay.
Yeah, I mean, that just goes back to the emphasis on a plan. So, you know, just like any business, we're a business like everybody else. I've said that many times. And, you know, we have to do the same thing that we're saying with our clients. We've got to protect our people. We've got to protect our operations. And we've got to protect our liquidity. And I would even add in our business, and this might be true of other businesses, you know, we're in the business of protecting our clients as well. So we've kind of got a fourth factor that we have to be concerned with. But you know, those things hold true for
I don't want our clients to kid themselves, right? Don't know the date on your calendar that you can circle that you might get this economic impact disaster loan money. You don't know the date on the calendar that they're even going to take your CARES application, let alone when it's going to funnel through the SBA, let alone when it's going to fund. The dollar amounts of either, quite frankly. All right, so you can't count on that. We had a client a week or two ago tell you or me or somebody, I just don't remember, that they were going to liquidate $400,000 of inventory and that'll help them with cash, and got nowhere. Because if you couldn't do it when things were okay, going to be kind of tough to do it today.
Right.
So don't kid yourself. You have to look in the mirror and see your warts and deal with them. I suggested to someone the other day that they contact their landlord, let them know what they could do over the next 3 months, and whether the landlord liked it or not, this is what needed to happen. Because if you don't protect your liquidity, you're not going to be there in 3 months. Yeah. You know, so these are tough decisions and tough calls, and we don't ever wake up wanting to hurt anyone or any business. But I want our clients and the people that we work with to come out of this okay and a month, 2 months, 3 months, or 3 months of hell.
Yeah. One of the things that I say a lot, and again, I've said it through the series, is if you don't ask, the answer is no. There's no risk in you calling your landlord, calling your creditors, calling your vendors, calling whoever, and trying to work out deals. Now, you know, you got to kind of understand the day and age. You know, they're not real quick to give anything. Some are better positioned for it and are more reasonable than others, but. You know, I always thought that the onus is on our clients, on the business owners, and then by extension us, because we're the help for them. But the onus is on us to be the aggressor in that. Your landlord or your bank or your vendors, they're not going
to come to you, right?
Right, exactly. They're not going to come to you. So if you don't take the initiative to go out to them and see what you can do realistically, then first off, I think that's just irresponsible.
Not smart. Right.
Right. It's not. It's very irresponsible, because in this time when everybody's kind of freaking out, more communication in my mind is better. So as you're going through this process, you've got to be the one initiating. You're the one that has to call your landlord, and you're the one that has to call your vendors and have a plan in place for them. And look, they may say no, or you're crazy, we're not going to do that, or we can't do that, because they're stressing and they need cash flow as well. They're looking at their liquidity and their business.
I had someone call me the other day, and his business was in a strip mall. And every store in the strip mall was closed because none of them were deemed essential. And his rent was like $2,800 or $2,200 a month or whatever it is. So I said to him, tell your landlord you can pay him based on his liquidity $200 this month, $300 next month, and $400 the month after. And then whatever months were left on the lease, there were 12 months left. The 12 months starts 90 days from now, so he still gets his money. He told me the landlord almost hugged him because it was someone actually paying him something, right? So I think there's methods and ways to go about things that can protect everybody's integrity, and that matters. So folks, Take the offensive with your bank. Talk to your bank 2-3 times a day. Make sure your line of credit's active. Make sure your ACH capability is active. Make sure your open lines of communication with the bank stay strong. Talk to your key vendors. Sometimes they can finance you. Sometimes they can help you with liquidity. Talk to your key accounts. Maybe some of them are so strong they can prepay you for something because it's in their best interest to keep you liquid and afloat if you didn't walk into this with a strong balance sheet, with a strong environment. So, Mike, I want to sort of tie this together in a couple of areas, okay? So, one thing, safeguard and communicating with your employees always matters. Communicating and planning with your vendors and your key accounts, all your accounts matters because cash goes in, cash goes out, cash goes in, cash goes out. Preserve your liquidity. If there's bills and invoices you can split or not pay or defer, keep the cash in your checking account. And of course, a horse is a horse, of course. Anything you need anytime, you should be talking to us at American Management, listening to our podcast, The Hardball Profits Way. If you want to call us and talk and get some advice, the number is 855-876-5561. I think I actually said it right this time, Michael. Is that correct? All right. And if you call us and you want some help, you're going to be surprised. We don't want anything for it other than goodwill. We'll hook up with you down the road. We want to help as many people as possible. Be okay. Read some articles that there is some projections that almost 40% of small businesses may not make it through the next 3 months of hell. I guarantee you American Management's clients are going to make it through the next 3 months of hell. You want to talk to us, you're either going to talk to me, Lou Mosca, Michael Lockie, or my brother Chris, who is the survey director. You call anytime, 855-876-5561. If you don't have cash, if you don't have liquidity, if you don't have a plan to get through this crisis financially, you are in deep crap. That consulting phrase again, deep crap. Okay. Mike, what you got to sign off?
We actually started this series by saying the business owners have to be the leaders in this whole thing. Be aggressive. Again, if you don't ask the questions, no. Protect your people, protect your operations, but protect your liquidity. Stay on top of your banks. Stay on top of your creditors. Stay on top of your debtors. But be the aggressor, be the leader in all of this, and make sure you're working to a plan.
Keep listening to us, folks, on Hardball Profits, as the Hardball Profits podcast, as we will be bringing you what do you call this darn thing? The Hardball Profits Way. Keep listening to us, folks. We're going to bring you one or two episodes every week. And I'm telling you, if you talk to us and listen to us, we will give you the ammunition and the tools you need to survive 3 months of hell and be the last man standing. Have a great day, folks.